This video is brought to you by Storyblocks. Click the first link in the description below to learn more. Another 5 euros for the Sri Lanka funding. Thanks a lot, Janik. If you haven't checked it out yet, we're currently raising money for better schooling in Sri Lanka. Any donation or social media share is highly appreciated. There's a link in the description below to all the information. Anyways, welcome to Copycat Friday, a weekly series in which we recreate a visual effect from a famous film or music video. Hollywood is recreating every cartoon from my childhood, and Robin Hood, well, it couldn't escape as well. The film is still rolling in theaters, I've only seen the trailer, so let me know in the comments if you've seen the film and what your thoughts were. But that's not why we're here, I'm gonna teach you how to shoot arrows like Robin Hood, or probably even better.
We just created a street light with combining a green filter and an orange filter. We did this to create this ugly orange light because every street light is an ugly orange light. I was building the set, as you can see, but I forgot the most important thing. The street light. Yay! Break it all off! Some of you will recognize this go-kart. We used it in the Maroon 5 Girls Like These, I think. But now, it's a memorabilia. And we use it as a prop in the movies.
For those of you wondering right now why we shot everything on the GH5 and not the brand new RET, well, the RET apparently had a sensor issue since we got it. We're currently in contact with RET and probably have to send it back. Now that's like taking away candy from a child. You don't do that. Damn it. We shot everything in our studio and created a city street at night. The sound design from the skit in the beginning came from Storyblocks, who are sponsoring us today. It's a huge audio and music library. The amazing thing is that you only have to pay a single price per month or per year, which allows you to download as many audio clips as you want. Usually I would download a bunch of sound effects, start my edit, and maybe only use half of the clips that I downloaded. And that's the cool thing about having unlimited access to this library. You can experiment and try out different things without having to pay extra. For more information, make sure to visit the first link in the description below. Now let's go back into the studio where we have changed the setup a little bit to make everything brighter so that's going to be easier to follow with the tutorial. Now I'm a terrible shooter, so what we did was put the camera on a tripod. Janik would stand in front of the camera with an apple on his head. With a little tape, I mark where the apple on his head aligns with the monitor. At a specific moment, Janik will shake his head so that the apple will drop. Once the apple has fallen, Janik will make that same movement again. And this is gonna be very important, guys. Then we swap Janik with a light stand and an apple on top of it. Then we'll line that apple with your marker so that it sits somehow on the same place. The camera stays rolling and you just fire your bow and pierce an arrow through the apple.
I'll hit him! I'm standing so close to the apple, yet I'm missing. I'll hit him!
Jordy destroyed the apple.
So we need a new one. Ole!
So you hit the apple after 20 takes. Everyone can cheer now and you can stop the recording. And of course, guys, you can also throw a knife if you don't have a bow. Just as long as you keep it safe. If you are a minor, make sure that one of your parents is helping out.
And Janik, catch!
Okay, now we can jump into Premiere. Start off by placing your victim in the second track of your timeline. Search for the point where Janik makes his movement. Right at the start, add a cut. Then scrub further in time, where he makes that same movement again, but this time without the apple on his head. Add a cut here as well, and close the gap. We now have a jump cut, but because Janik makes a sudden movement, it's not gonna be that noticeable. Next up, we're gonna take my shot where I fire the arrow. but it has to be synced with the other clip. So what I'll do before I add it to the timeline is set an endpoint from the source monitor right where the arrow hits the apple. And then I drag this clip into the timeline in track one, starting from the point where Jennik makes his movement, which is that jump cut. You can then go ahead and trim the clip back to the beginning. For the convenience now, I'm going to select both of the upper clips, right-click and choose Nest. And this way, they are grouped together and we can manage it as one single clip now. Select it, go to Effect Controls, and under Opacity, click on the Pen tool. With this, we can draw a rough mask around Jennik. Make sure to leave room for where I stand and above Jennik, where the arrow is going to fly through. And this will reveal the clip underneath, which is me standing with the bow. Search for the point where the arrow reaches the apple. Here, I'm going to enable the animation for the mask path. Go one frame forward and move the mask underneath the apple. The other apple, which sits on that light stand, will now reveal itself. You might need to adjust your mask for a frame or two while the arrow flies further. Once it's done, you can enlarge the mask again. Now, since everything was shot from a tripod, you could add one of our free handheld presets to it, which makes it a bit more dynamic. There's a download link in the description below if you want to check it out. The arrow shot from the intro went exactly the same, only here we had some trouble to get the arrow stuck in the wall, so eventually we just stuck it in there and gave it a bump to make the arrow wiggle. With a simple jump cut, it worked out perfect. And that's how to win the next America's Got Talent. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to check out our fundraising. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And like always, stay creative.
So I made this bow a few years ago from PVC, and I did this by watching a YouTube video, and he is famous for making bows out of PVC. And this one is inspired by the bows from the elves from The Hobbit, one of my favorite movies.
Nerd!